Hi students, welcome to Social Studies online classes. Dear IT class students, today we are going to start our Social Studies first chapter, Reading and Analysis of Maps. Reading and Analysis of Maps. Before we discuss about this chapter, we have to remember the previous year, first chapters of the 7th class, first chapter of the 6th class. In 6th class, we have studied reading and making maps. Isn't it? Is it? In 7th class, we studied reading maps of different kinds. In 6th, we studied reading and making maps. In 7th, we studied reading maps of different kinds. In 8th, we are studying about reading and analysis of maps. So before we get into the details of this chapter, let me remind you, reading and making maps in the chapter, we are studying about what maps gives us, what information, what is a sketch map, what is the political map, what is thematical map, what is physical map that we studied. Reading maps of different kinds in 7th class of social studies, first chapter we studied about that. The maps tells us several information, even the geographically, the comparing the heights from the mean sea levels and the different categories which were analyzed. Like the physical maps gives us the maximum information of the mountains, plains, plateaus, islands, deserts, coastal plains. These are all the information we have studied in the 7th class. Reading maps of different kinds. Now we are arriving at the 8th topic of the first chapter, Reading and Analysis of Maps. Reading and analysis of the maps, this chapter gives us the information about actually maps were prepared by whom in the ancient times. Why does a man got idea to prepare a map? Why the people are prepared maps? How they designed the structure of this world? How they identified, how they predicted the what place is where located, which country is located in that place, how does it happen? Reading and analysis of maps. We shall study about this information in this chapter. How was maps are prepared? What was maps are prepared? And what is the importance of the maps? Basically, geographers needed the maps to find out the information of the world. If we get into the history of the map founders, the maps were prepared by the ancestors like Sumerians, Babylonians, Europeans, Chinese, etc. The people are prepared the maps in ancient times. So now we are going to discuss about this chapter, the maps, the analysis of the maps, the uses of the maps, how do we have to analyze the maps that we can study in this chapter. Let me tell you, physical maps tells us about. What does physical maps tells us? What does physical maps show us? Physical maps show us about mountains, plains, plateaus, coastal plains, coastal plateaus, Deccan plateaus, deserts, islands, the information we can get to physical maps. Political maps tells us about countries, states, districts. Political maps tells us countries, states, districts, even the mandals, villages, also we can find the political maps. Thematical maps. Thematical maps means in this chapter there are the several colors are indicated by the thematical name. In a map, wherever we can find the green color, that we can predict as that area is covered with full of forest. If suppose in a map, if you find the complete blue color, we can predict that is a ocean, that is a sea, or that is a river, or that is a tank. That we can find out. So the special color where it was indicating that color, the theoretical maps which can express about the theoretical map color express about a special thing like forests, mountains, even the water bodies. The things are the mostly populated density areas. That one special thing can be indicated by the theoretical maps. Topographic maps show as big buildings, towers, and the different kinds of the categories which we can find and which we can guess, which we can predict through the topographic maps. And now let's just see the themes of this chapter. Map down the edges. In the ancient times, in the previous times, how does the maps are prepared? Why does the maps are prepared? So maps are prepared to move on to the one area to another area, to reach out to the one area to another area. So to investigate the something, the goods or trading system, for the trading purpose also, the dark ages, the maps are prepared. Basically, the maps which can come to the Kodlu, here the maps were not same as compared to the ancient maps. At the time of earlier times, at the time we can see the maps are not comparing to the present generation times. Well, we can see the different moderating apps, the population maps, geographical information maps, historical maps, and physical maps, political maps, the modified designs, the new maps. Digitally we can find the maps compared to the present maps, where we can compare the maps of the present generation to the previous, like which was prepared by the Babylonians, Sumerians, or Idrisi, who was prepared map for his king of the world. The Idrisi, one of the example was given in this chapter. Idrisi, once upon a time he was prepared a map for his king. Which map he was prepared, Idrisi? World map. He was prepared world map for his king to show, to present the map which world map was prepared by the Idrisi. The map he was prepared for his king, which was also happened in the earlier times. So let's see next. Colonization, explorations, military use, and the map making. Colonization, explorations, military use, and map making. During the time of colonization, which means our Europeans who were occupied in the North America, in South America, in Europe, even in Asia, in Australia, in all the continents of the world, Europeans are occupied to do the trading, to do the business. They occupy, they enter into the all the countries to do the business. Europeans have started colonizing to the all continents like North America, South America, Africa, Australia, Asia. In all these continents, Europeans have started colonizing, which means Europeans are occupying all these continents. And then they started the trading system. Before they started the trading system, they entered into those countries and they started the trading. Before the trading, how they were found these routes to enter into the countries? So we can see the Europeans when they started colonization. The colonization, if we go and if you get into the details of the colonization, Europeans found the several maps like Columbus, and who was reached to the East India, and East Indies, and he predicted that was India, but that was not India. He reached to the East Indies, and he named that was India. No, that was not India. Just the example was given there in the chapter. In this manner, during the colonization times, during the colonization period, the Europeans are started to search another places like the neighbor. There are the 7 islands on the earth. There are 7 islands on the earth. They identify with the Europeans are started reaching from one place to another. A voyage navigation traveling was done by the Europeans while the colonizing, while the entering into the one place to another place. This was the basic phenomenon which we can predict from one area to another area while they reaching, or suppose the one location of the area, or in the trading system, or in the investigate system, or in the inspection system, where the geographers wanted to know about the world. They started traveling to the water bodies. They continuously traveled. When they were reached to the land part, at that time they started from that part to their country, from that part to the Europe, they started the trading. The trading system was continuously gone, and the several countries became harassed. The countries had to face many hungry strikes. The countries had to face the massive shortage because the Europeans have started colonizing, the Europeans have started entering into the other continents as their inspection by the geographers to reach one place to another place, to go one place to another place. So these are the situations during the time of the colonization. In these aspects, the several countries, kings, they started, they entered, they advised to their soldiers to go and inquire about the world, wherever the islands are located, wherever the landmasses are located. In these aspects, Sumerians, Babylonians, and the Sumerians and Babylonians are belongs to present day Iraq. So that the people who are also entering into the civil Sumerians, Babylonians are the firstly they prepared the clay tablets, clay type models they were prepared. Clay type models they prepared and they presented to their kings. This was the map. So where we were traveled, where we found the land piece. While the traveling, the voyage continuation, they found the complete land piece. In that land piece, after the reaching that, they entered into that part, they occupied that part, they stayed some time in that part, and they inquired about that part. What kind of people are living there? What language speaking people are living there? Which continuation people are living there? And what food habits they have? These are all the things were expected by the Europeans while they during the time of colonization period as they traveled to the long durations. Use of maps in our times. See, most probably the geographers used to go one place to another place. The geographers needed the maps inspection, the maps identification, the maps foundation, and the maps invention, most probably used by the use of maps in our times also. The geographers are the main important task come here to identify, to know about that. The map is map is needed to the geographers. So which we can expect here, basically which we can know that the use of maps in our times, use of maps in the earlier times also, the use of maps in river times, so like identifying the different categories, like physical features of the maps, things as good mountains, plains, plateaus, deserts, islands, and the route maps, to reaching one area to another area, route maps, and the moving about the geographic information, like where the forests are located, where the water bodies are located, where the snowfall was located, the which region tells us what, and the region's climate is what, and whatever regenerate it is bottom, the uses of mass in our time and in the earlier times also. Reading thematic map. See, reading thematic map, thematical maps. Reading thematic maps. My dear students of health standard, you have to see, you have to observe in your textbook. Some symbols are given, some colors are given, that you want to identify what color is saying what. So on the map, if suppose the green color is indicated, which means we can expect the color is green color is belonging to the forest, blue color is belonging, blue color is indicating here water bodies, brown color is indicating here lands, different types of the lands. That we can identify. So you have to identify, you have to mention your favorites also by shading the colors, by thematic that colors, what color is indicating what in the map. Thematical maps tell us the special feature of the area, the special identification of the area. Make a population map. Make a population map, which means what is the population density of an area? What is the specification of an area? Where we can find the different types of the situations? Where we can identify? Suppose the make a population map, which means suppose Adilabad district, in Adilabad district, Rangareddy is the one. Rangareddy is one of the other district. And then just the compare to Adilabad in Telangana, compare to Adilabad and Rangareddy district. In these two districts, we can identify Rangareddy stands highly in the respect of population. So, make a population map by comparing the other districts of your district. The population maps, especially, we can prepare here in the density of the area. The population density can calculate where the high amount of the people are living in the span of kilo square kilometer. In the kilo square meter, how many people are living? That we can see. Who prepared maps? What is the theme of this chapter? The intervention questions you want to study and write the answers. And the individual learning questions also you want to mention in your favorites. And the identification of the thematical maps, different colors are, different symbols are given in this chapter. That you want to put into your notes. Thank you.